Hello everybody, this is Tekka. In this video, what I'm going to be doing is showing you some important post-installation steps after you install EndeavorOS. If you didn't know, EndeavorOS is my Linux distribution of choice. I absolutely love it. It's as close as you're going to get to Arch with some just a little bit of extra tools and a wonderful Calamaris installer. And this right here is EndeavorOS. I went ahead and installed the GNOME version. I've been rather fond of GNOME lately, and I'm going to be talking about that in a future video. So make sure you're subscribed and you ring that bell so you do not miss that. But getting right into these steps, the very first thing you're going to notice when you install EndeavorOS is this right here. This is their welcome application. Now, a lot of people kind of just gloss over this. They close it out. They click don't show me anymore right away. But there's really some nice steps here that make the actual post-installation process a lot easier, especially under this after install tab, which is specifically what this is for. I recommend going through just about all of this. What we're going to do first is update our mirrors. I've already done a lot of this, so I don't technically need to do it again, but I'll run through the process. What you're going to want to do in this is go ahead and select where you are in the world. You can see I have United States, include HTTPS. We're going to want to sort by rate, keep this at 10, hit OK. And then what this application is going to do is actually rank the available download locations in a specific order. And then when it is all done, there should be another pop-up here that will create a config file that we can save to our Pac-Man Deer mirror list. So you just hit save, you're gonna type in our password real quick, and now our mirrors have been updated. From there, you could do a system update through here, or if you want to, you just open up the terminal, type sudo pacman-syu, and do the same exact thing, or you do it through yay, hit enter, and then this will begin a full update of our system. So once you have that done, you can proceed to the next step, and that's a package cleanup configuration. And this will basically just clean up the cache of your Pac-Man package manager. Generally, I just keep this at default, type in your password, and you're good to go. From here, you can do a couple other things that I'm not really gonna get into, such as configuring the update notifier. You can set those settings however you want. You can change your display manager if you'd like to. I just keep this the same depending on what desktop environment I'm actually using. I go with what is stock for that. Since I'm on GNOME, I'm going to stick with GDM. So go ahead and close that out. And here we have some wallpaper things. Now I'm briefly going to talk about wallpapers. Depending on the desktop environment you're in, the steps might be a little bit different. If I go ahead and click on this default wallpaper, this is what ships. And the wallpaper that you saw in the beginning is one of the community wallpapers. So what you're going to want to do is go download more Endeavor wallpapers, and it's going to go through the process. And I actually have already done this, so I'm going to go ahead and close that out. But you're going to want to type in your password, download all of those, and then we're going to make it so you can easily change those. So if I go to choose one of the EndeavorOS wallpapers, this we can actually choose it through here, but it's not as efficient as doing it through our actual settings. So what we're going to want to do is actually import these wallpapers. So I'm going to right click on the desktop, I'm going to hit change background, and you can see I already have a lot of these because I've already done this. But to do this, what you're going to want to do is go add picture, and then you're going to want to travel to this directory, user share EndeavorOS backgrounds. So we'll go to our home directory, go to the user share EndeavorOS backgrounds. And here is where you could go ahead and import all those. So to import all the classic wallpapers, I would just go ahead and select all of these, hit open, then I'd open this up again, go under community, select all of these, and then hit open, and that will import all those wallpapers. And then we could do the EndeavorOS wallpaper, open that up, and now that should be in there. So that is our default wallpaper. For now, I'm gonna go ahead and switch this back to the one I had, which I'm really fond of this one. There are some wonderful EndeavorOS wallpapers. For example, this one right here is really nice. This is the one that I was just using, and this is the one I'm going to keep for now. So let's close that out, close this out, and within this assistant, there's some other things that we could do, such as getting some general info on our system to take you to the EndeavorOS forums, wiki, things like that. We have the assistant, so this is going to allow us to do a couple more things, such as update our system, mirrors again. We have some package manager utilities. We can browse Arch packages or AUR packages. For example, if I click this right here, it's going to take us to the Arch repository page where we could actually see all the packages available in our repository. But one thing I want to do, I'm kind of a normie when it comes to using Linux. I use Yay a lot, but I really enjoy the PaMac package manager. That's the default package manager that ships with Manjaro, and I like to have it on Endeavor OS. So one thing, if you want AUR packages, Yay is already installed from default on Endeavor OS, which is awesome. You can see we can do a system update through here. We've already ran an update, so there's nothing we really need to do. But one thing I want to do is search for the PaMac-all package. If I give that a search, you can see it right here. And what this is going to do is give us a beautiful GUI package manager. I'm going to go with the first option. For this, I'm going to go with the default. And I'm going to go with the default. And we're going to go with the default, which is no. And last but not least, I do not want to show any of those, and install. So now it's going to run through. This might take a little bit because this is kind of a larger application, but trust me, especially if you're somebody like me who actually likes to use the search functionality and see the pictures and the descriptions of all the different applications, this is absolutely wonderful. All right, and once we are done here, we're going to go ahead and close out our terminal, go over to activities, and search for PaMac. It's going to show up as add remove software. If we go ahead and open that up, you can see here it is. This is our graphical package manager. And in addition to getting AUR packages and all that, with the dash all, we could go ahead and actually open up our terminal and do a PaMac command. You could actually use this to list packages, install, remove, reinstall, update. Anything that you could do with pacman or yay, you could do with the PaMac command as well. So let's go ahead and close that out. Open up this add remove software once more, and there's a couple things that we're going to want to do in here. So right here, this little hamburger menu, let's click on that, open up preferences. It's going to ask for our password. Caps lock is on, so let's undo that, type in our password, and here we're going to want to change some settings. You could change your update frequency. There's a lot of things that you could do just on your own. Depending on your internet speed, we could change our parallel download count. Mine's pretty good, so I'm going to switch that to 10. Under advanced, we have a couple more options, such as checking available disk space if that's a concern for you. You can remove unrequired dependencies and more. You have ignored upgrades here, and this is an important option to keep note of, especially if you are using an application that you don't want to upgrade. You can set that in here, or if you're using it because you had to like tweak a package for some reason and you don't want a configuration to get overwritten, this is a place to do that. Now, if we go under third party, this is where we can have some fun. We're going to go ahead and enable AUR support. And here you have a couple more options. I generally select check for updates. And now from here, if we scroll down, here is where you can enable Flatpak or Snap support. I'm going to get some heat for this, but generally I go ahead and enable Snap support. I have better luck with flat packages in Fedora systems. And I actually have pretty good luck with Snap packages in Arch-based systems, even though that's like an Ubuntu thing. It works out perfectly for me. So now if I go ahead and close this out, we can do something like, you can see I was already kind of playing around, search for Discord here. And then you can see I have a couple different versions. I have the Discord through the Snap package, the official repositories. They're both on the same version here. And then I have these other versions as well and AUR versions. For Discord, I've had really good luck with the Snap package, and this can be completely different for you. But this is generally what I go with, and you can see how easy it was to search and install packages. If you look over here, we can also go to the AUR only, Snap packages only, or repository listings only. So I'm going to move this to the side, and the thing that's really nice about Endeavor OS, there's really not much to do. I've done just about everything that there is to do just out of the gate after you install. The system is ready to go, and you can begin the next and final step, and that is customizing it or ricing it to make it your own. In GNOME, what I would do is go ahead, open up like Firefox, for example, go to the GNOME extensions page and begin adding and configuring things with this as I would see fit. If I were in KDE Plasma, I would just open up settings, get the theming, switch everything to Nordic, which is probably what I'm gonna do in just a minute with this. And if you are running GNOME and you're interested in switching over to Nordic, I have a tutorial or a little guide on configuring Ubuntu the way I prefer. And that works exactly the same as with this or any other GNOME system. so you could check out that video if you would like. With all that said, there is a link down below if you are interested in learning more about Endeavor OS. And I'm going to be doing a video, like I said, on GNOME versus KDE. And this is coming from somebody who, like me, who used KDE for like a year and a half and have recently started getting into GNOME. So subscribe, ring that bell so you do not miss that video. Additionally, I'll have a video coming out on a list of my favorite Linux distributions. And surprise, surprise, this is going to be on there. So a little spoiler for that. With all that said, I would like to thank our YouTube members and Patreon supporters. We have Mitchell Valentino, executive level. Thank you so much for that. Additionally, we have Timo, Anthony, Philmac, and Kyle. And thank you to all the other Techie and Techie Plus members and supporters. If you're interested in supporting, there'll be links down below, or you can just hit the join button. With all that said, I hope this helped you out just a little bit. Have a beautiful day, and goodbye.